Using interactions, we can trigger a simple animation which shows and hides a drop-down menu. There's a ton of flexibility here, as you can animate any aspect of what's going on. In this video lesson, we're going to build a custom drop-down menu using interactions, and we're going to do it in four main sections. The components we're going to build, the first is the drop-down wrapper. This contains all the elements we're putting into the drop-down. The second is the drop-down trigger. This is what we see before clicking on the menu, and it's also what triggers the animation. And the third is the drop-down content. This is where we can place the stuff in the drop-down. And fourth, the last step is creating the interaction. We'll create a trigger which will animate the drop-down. In the end, we'll have a fully functional, responsive menu, which you'll more than likely want to share with your family, your friends, and the original cast of Star Trek The Next Generation. Let's start with the first part. In fact, all three of these, they're simple div blocks. So let's build exactly that. Let's go over to the add panel and drag in our first div block. This one's going to be the drop-down wrapper. We'll name our class. For clarity, we'll name this drop-down wrapper. You can name yours whatever you want. Then we'll add two things to our styling. We'll set a width. We can always change this later. For now, let's do 500 pixels. And the second thing we'll add to our styling is a change to our position. We'll set this to relative. That's the drop-down wrapper. Next up, the trigger. Let's get another div block from the add panel, and we'll put it inside the drop-down wrapper. And we'll do this in the navigator since our current wrapper has no height, which can be difficult to drag something into. And in the style panel, we can add a class to this div block too. This class is drop-down trigger. And you can put whatever you want in this trigger. You can even leave it blank. For today's demonstration, we'll put in a text block. We'll drag it right into the drop-down trigger. Make sure it's nested inside. And we'll double-click to change the text. We'll call it abstract art, which makes absolutely no sense. So we'll change the text to menu. We can also play with other styling options here too. Let's select our drop-down trigger. So if we want, we can set a background color or an image or a gradient, and we'll set that right here. Let's also give our text some breathing room by setting padding, holding shift and dragging to set padding on all four sides at once. But that's it, that's the second step. Now that we have the trigger done, let's add the drop-down content. As we reviewed in the beginning, both the drop-down trigger and the drop-down content are children of the drop-down wrapper. So we'll drag a new div block, this is going to be our content, we'll drag it right into the drop-down wrapper. And we're going to place it underneath the drop-down trigger. We can visually verify that we've done this correctly because the alignment between the trigger and the wrapper is identical in the navigator. And the content can be anything. We'll create a class and we'll name it drop-down content. We'll do a few things here. First, we'll set the positioning to absolute. Why? Because we don't want our drop-down to push around other content on the page. We'll also set our width to 100%, so it takes up all the available space, 100% of the width, inside the drop-down wrapper. Finally, we'll make sure our overflow is set to hidden. This will help us when we create the interaction later. Just like we configured the drop-down trigger, we can add a background color here too. We don't have to, but we will. And for our content, we'll do a few link blocks. Let's drag a link block from the add panel and make sure that we drop it right inside our drop-down content. Let's add a class to this one too. We'll call this drop-down link. To make this full width, we can go over and change our display setting to block. And we can do the same thing we did to the drop-down trigger here too. Let's add padding on all four sides by holding shift and dragging. And we can put some text inside. We'll simply drag a text block right into our link block. And we notice two things. One, the text is exactly where we placed it. And two, the text is hideous. Its blueness and its underline evoke a sensation not felt since 1997's release of Internet Explorer 4.0. And we can change this a number of ways, but we'll simply select our link block, the drop-down link, and make those two changes. Text to a better color, like a dark gray or black, and the underline to not underline. For this example, we'll make sure our link block is still selected and we'll copy and paste a few more times. Then we'll use technology called editing to remove the time it took us to rename each of these. But those are our three main elements, the wrapper, the trigger, and the content. Let's create the interaction. Pretty straightforward here. We'll select our trigger and we'll go over and create the interaction. We want this to trigger on the selected element, which we've coincidentally named trigger, and we want it to occur on mouse click or tap. On the first click, we'll create a new animation. Let's name it drop-down open. And this is going to be fairly simple. We'll select our drop-down content div. We can get to it by selecting any of its children and using the menu at the bottom to simply click on that element. And we'll build the animation. first thing we want to do is create a point right at the beginning. This is going to let us set the size, and we'll simply set the height to 0. Now remember, we set the overflow to hidden on the dropdown content, so it simply disappears. Let's make sure this is the initial state. We don't want the dropdown content showing up when the page loads. Then we'll create one more point after this. We'll make sure it affects size again, but instead of 0 pixels, let's put in 100 pixels. If we hit play, it looks super messed up. We don't want to go in and measure manual pixels each time. Instead, we can simply select from the right side of the input and choose auto. If we hit play, it works perfectly. Let's set a more attractive type of easing from the dropdown. We can play with different ones here, like bounce, which bounces, or swing from to, or in expo, or out elastic. You can pick whatever you want. And we can adjust our duration. If we go to preview this, we can see that upon clicking the dropdown trigger, our dropdown content is brought into view. If we click again, nothing happens. It doesn't collapse because we haven't told it what to do on second click. So let's tell it what to do on second click. Let's go out of this animation and add a new timed animation to the second click. We can call this one dropdown close. We need to make sure we're not animating the trigger itself, of course. That means selecting again the dropdown content. And since after the first click, the height is auto, the second click will simply have a single action. And we'll just set the size back to 0 pixels. Of course, we can mess with the easing here too, choose anything we want, and we'll adjust our duration. Once we do that, when we're ready for preview, let's go to preview. And you can see that it works. Two quick notes. It might feel unnatural for you for the dropdown hover to show the regular mouse cursor. You can always select your trigger div block and change the type of cursor that's used. Simply select pointer, or really any type of cursor, at any time to get it looking and feeling just how you want it to. That's the first quick note. The second is this. What if you want your dropdown menu to activate on hover instead of click or tap? Instead of choosing click, we can build the same thing on hover. Just replace first click with hover in and the second click with hover out. But we've done what we came here to do. We created a dropdown wrapper that contains all our elements. We created a trigger. We created and added to our content. And finally, we built out the animation. We expand upon this technique in other content we created, so check out our video lesson on creating an accordion, which is super useful for creating an FAQ. But that's creating a custom dropdown menu in the Webflow Designer.